All I'm saying is I think exercising in groups is disgusting and you should never do it.
This is the first year that my New Year's resolutions didn't include doing sit-ups and shit and getting in shape. First year that's ever happened, you know? I figured we about to die, so. Why would I do that? Why would I not doing any fucking sit? Like, what if the bomb hits and you in a plank position? How mad would you be? How mad would you? I would be furious. Like, no, fuck that. I'm not doing. No, I'm not going out like no bitch. You know? I want to die with a bagel in my hand. You know what I mean? Fuck that.
I played basketball for cardio, all right? But not just with anybody. Every Tuesday, I meet a specific group of friends at the park because we all suck and nobody wants to get hurt. It's a kind game. I never talk trash, but I giggle a lot. Yeah, because my mind wants to do all these things that my body does not execute. When I get the ball, my mind's like, okay, we're gonna do a crossover, we're gonna do a spin move, and we're gonna finish with a very graceful finger roll. And my body's like, actually, we're gonna pass this ball out of bounds. Turnover, giggle time. It's a public space. I can't control if other people want to shoot hoops, but I can tell if I don't want to play with somebody right away. Like, one red flag is if they look fit. I'm like, oh, you healthy, huh? Okay. That's good, man. That's good for you. I bet you've got skills. But that's not what this is about. No, man, me and my friends, everybody, we all here because we got diseases. High blood pressure, high cholesterol, diabetes, fatty liver. We're not here to play games. We're here to delay death. You can come back with the doctor's note.
Zoom in. This is me flexing as hard as I possibly can. Yo, I thought I was killing it with tricep. There's no tricep. All right, zoom back out. Look, I look the same, right? This is my best friend, Will Morosky, okay? This is what Will Morosky looks like now. Blow up! Yo, Will Morosky is built like a Greek god. Pecs, abs, bulge. I cannot stop thinking about Will Morosky. Dude, sometimes when it's late at night, I'll be in bed. And I will pull out my phone. And I will slowly scroll through Will's profile. And Bina will wake up. And she'll be like, are you looking at OnlyFans? And I'm like, nah, it's only Will. I'm really happy for him. But this is so depressing. But it's still not as depressing as that goddamn photo of Kumail Nanjiani. Fuck this photo. Don't clap. Don't you dare clap at this photo. This is a personal attack. No! This is a personal attack! When he dropped this photo, he low-key tagged every brown dude in this room. Do you understand? He tagged all of us. He's like, hey, what's up, man? I'm Kumail. What's up, man? I'm from Karachi. What are you doing with your life? I'm like, fuck you, Kumail! How dare you show white people what we could look like?
Whenever I tell people I want to lose weight, they're like, you should go to the gym. I'm like, I know. For sure. But whenever I go to the gym and I see people with abs, it's like, why are you still here? You did it. Like, get a hobby for once. I don't know. I know working out is good for mental health. I do suffer from depression, or as I like to call it, crying because outside smells like the past. I love nostalgia. It hurts and feels bad. Boop. But when I go to the gym, I just cannot connect with those people. If you're someone who uses and cleans a blender every day, it's like, what's really going on? What's going on?
That's what I do now, by the way. I hike It's my thing now. I hike. Hiking is not my exercise. It's my activity. Because hiking is not exercise. Hiking is the segue between the actual exercise you did in your 20s and 30s and then the gentle mall walking that you're gonna do in your 70s and 80s so that you'll fit into the tuxedo at the funeral home. Because you don't want them splitting the back of the jacket open. That's embarrassing. Come on. Let's die with some dignity. So what I do every day, I park my car at the base of a hiking trail. Then I walk away from my car until I eventually turn around and walk back to my car.
I started riding my bike along a lakefront path, and there was always a guy at the entrance. I don't know if he had a home, who's to know? He was always there, okay? And about 3 months into my workout regime, he wanted to let me know that he noticed, so he yelled out to me, "How fit are you gonna get?" And I said, "I think I'm done. I just found the love of my life." Which is basically all a relationship is. It's like, is it safe to eat again? Okay. Never mind. I do. I hate to pin it on men, but you're not the best at noticing what's different about a woman, you know? Whether it's like a haircut or losing 50 pounds. And I ran into an old friend I hadn't seen in a while, and he was trying to figure out what was different about me, you know? Giving me the old side eye. And then what he came up with was, "Man, your tits got small." And I said, "Thank you." Thanks for noticing the least positive aspect of my weight loss. You see weight loss ads where there's like a man who has very large pants in front of him. You never see one where a woman has a big bra and she's like, "It doesn't fit."
I do zero working out. Not even, I mean, I don't, it's not like you're like, "Whoa, wow." Like it's like, yeah, we figured that. Every hotel I go to, I ask if they have a gym. I don't even have clothes that I could work out in. There's no way. I'm like, is it 24 hours? I was gonna start tonight at midnight. So I was wondering if that's, what I've learned, what's easier than working out is just tell people that you used to weigh 300 pounds. That's a lot. They don't know, you know? So I've never weighed 300 pounds, but I look pretty amazing for a guy that used to weigh 300 pounds. You're like, yeah, I got tired of being tired, all right? You know? Today's my cheat day, obviously, but normally I'm pretty strict.
I took a spin class. I just wanted to go for the exercise part, but then they were doing all this inspirational yelling in the class. I don't care for that. I don't like that idea with exercise now of like, we're all in this together. It's like, no, we're not, Kelsey. We are not in this together. If I showed up at your house, you'd call the police. That's what would happen. But people get really into it. I'm just like, ugh. I don't like collective enthusiasm. I've never cared for that. Then they make you say things to the person next to you. She goes, "Everybody, I want you to look at the cyclist on your right. Give her a high five and say, get it, girl." I'm like, that's one of the worst things I've ever been asked to do.
Do you ever see people on a treadmill? They run fast and hard, like the whole gym could hear them running. It's like a sock is gonna fly off at any minute. Then he pulled this one. He just rested on the side and let the thing. Just do what we are doing. Don't do some weird workout that you saw. Then he, I've never seen this before. He had like a water backpack. Like that you would see in the desert. He had a backpack filled with water and then a tube that he could just sip. Then he dropped it down. Then he pulled this one. He turned towards me. Now he starts side skipping. Oh my God. I cannot run on a treadmill with another grown man looking right at me doing side skips. I came home, I told my wife this story. She don't get it. She don't understand. She's like, why do you look at everybody? Just do you. Why do you look at the whole gym? I go, because that's what makes me happy. I like to be bothered.
I go to the gym a lot. That's a good way to relax. I lift weights. It's hard to tell. I'm wearing long sleeves, but I like lifting weights. My favorite part of lifting weights is that break in between sets where you kind of check your phone and go home for a couple weeks. I'm enjoying that quite a bit. I gotta get back there in a few days. I got some more reps to crank out. I'm taking a breather, but I don't like my gym, though. My gym's all like bodybuilders, which no offense if you're a bodybuilder. I'm scanning the crowd. I feel like I'm safe to talk about bodybuilders here. I don't like the term bodybuilder. I feel like it's too exclusive. Technically, we're all bodybuilders. Just some of us are building shittier bodies than other people. You know what I mean?
6 a.m. I come to the gym. You got a guy in there my height, my build. Got my headgear, my codpiece, my mouthpiece. Puts it all on me, starts putting Vaseline all on my face and all on my headgear. I said, what's this for? He said, so the punches slide off. Well, we never talked. Okay, well, we didn't discuss that, but all right. Okay, all right, if that's what it's gonna do, then that's what it's gonna do. He gets done putting Vaseline on my face, he walks out the ring. I said, wait, you didn't do him yet. He said, he's okay, he don't need it. Huh, all right. That's weird. Okay, whatever. I'm gonna go with the flow. He said, guys, we're gonna do 3 3-minute rounds. Nobody's here to hurt anybody. Let's have a good time. Keep it loose. He yells out, take it easy on him. I assume he's talking to me. He's gotta be talking to me. I yell back, gotcha, coach. Put a confident laugh behind it. We get to our corners, the bell rings, ding, I come out. I just want him to see that I can fight. You can tell I can fucking fight by the way I hold my shoulders. Look how I'm moving, My feet are spaced apart. Look at my fucking foot moving. Look how I'm fucking moving, bitch. This ain't gonna be no cakewalk. Yeah. You see it. He flat-footed. Oh, he not even on the balls of his foot. I'm gonna whoop his ass. I'm getting more confidence as I move around. My coach says, Kevin, stop playing. Let your hands go. All right. Ask and you shall receive. I hope he got the Weather Channel. Because this is about to be some lightning. When you throw a jab, you take a step. Take a step. Let the jab go at the same time. Turn it over. Whap, every time. Whap. What? That's how you throw it. I take my step. I'm about to turn it over. I'm right here. Here it is. About to turn that bitch over. You better brace yourself. Here it come. Ooh, it's coming. Right here. I'm right here. But I'm about to get here. Here I am. But I'm about to fucking get right there. You better brace yourself. I'm right here. Before I did that, he hit me. I immediately lost my vision. Immediately. I went blind. Immediately. Couldn't see shit. Everything was fucking black. I read that you can get brain damage or you can die from a punch. I just lost my fucking vision. I don't have eyesight no more. I can't see. I panicked. I turned around. I've been known to do this move several times. I start punching backwards. I've talked about it in my past specials. I'm a backwards puncher when I panic. I fucking start punching. My trainer said, Kevin, throw the jab. Throw the jab. I said, for what? Liar. It ain't lightning unless he's a storm tracker, okay? Because this is fucking ridiculous. I'm blind. I can't see shit. Ah! I'm blind. Ring the bell. Ring the fucking bell. The bell rings. I can't even get to the corner. I gotta follow his voice to the corner. Ah! As I get to the corner, my trainer, he's like, what's wrong? I said, I'm blind, man. I can't fucking see. He just lift my headgear up. Apparently, when he hit me, he knocked my headgear over my eyes. It was black, so I was just looking at the back of it the whole time. He was like, why didn't you lift it up? And I said, because we never went over that in practice. I didn't know I could do that. I think you put too much Vaseline on me. That's why I was sliding all over the place. Sliding all over the fucking place. Man, I don't want to do this no more. He said, you just going to quit? I said, I don't call it quitting. I just want to do something else. He said, what are you going to tell him? I said, I'm never talking to him again in my fucking life. My lawyer going to talk to him. He's going to jail. I bet you that. He's going to fucking jail after this.